Hello and welcome to another Zach Carnage video, and this time we're going to be taking a look at the Duelist Alliance box for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Trading Card Game. This is a box with a lot of great cards in it, including Shaddolls, Satellarknights, Burning Abyss, and a ton of new Pendulum monsters, like Odd Eyes Pendulum Dragon on the front. Now, this box was sent to me by Cool Kingdom, so go ahead and check them out at their website, www.coolkingdom.co.uk. The link is in the description, as always, and let's go ahead and open this up. Now, inside of your booster box, you will find 24 packs of 9 cards per pack. These are all booster packs from Duelist Alliance, the brand new set that's just been released. You can see the lid actually turns into a neat little stand if you're planning on selling them. And we're going to go ahead and open up some of these packs. So let's take a look at what we've got. Now, this is, of course, a brand new set, so there are all sorts of stuff, all sorts of things which you can come out in the new sets, and it's going to be very exciting to take a look and see what we have. So we have some super heavy samurai cards, some random spell cards, artifacts, Yangzings, a new archetype, and performer pals as well. We have a resonance insect here, Nefarious Archfiend Eater of Nefariousness, Feast of the Wild level 5, and Satellarknight Vega. Now Satellarknights and Shaddolls are going to be among the priorities for people here, as well as the Burning Abyss cards, a new sort of Dante's Inferno type of archetype, which is going really well. I think a lot of people are planning on using it with tour guides, because they seem to be level 3 fiends, and they've got some pretty decent effects. So we've got Hippo Carnival, Cloud Castle, Metaphys Arm Dragon. This is the light version of the Dark Arm Dragon that we already have. Satellarknight Unukalai, Satellarknight Skybridge, Yangzin Creation, that's a very nice ultra rare there. Put that to the side. Cursed Shadow Prison, Battle Guard Howling, and Fishborg Doctor. So as I said before, 24 packs to get through, and this is the third one, so once we've done this, we'll be an eighth of the way through. Battle Guard King, the new Battle Guard card. To go with some, like, the old, very old Swamp Battle Guard, and I think Lava Battle Guard cards. Satellanova Wave, Perform Pal Swordfish. Here's one of the Burning Abyss cards. This is Skarm, Male Branch of the Burning Abyss. Super Heavy Samurai Swordsman, Resonance Insect, Perform Pal Skeeter Skimmer. And Gaia, the Midnight Sun. So we've got two different versions of Gaia. I believe one of them is a Polar Knight. And that's the other one. So they're going to go really well in your Chaos decks. So we've got support in this booster box for previously made archetypes as well. So if you're planning on just carrying on with your old decks, you know, feel free to pick up this box because it has a lot of useful cards for all sorts of decks. Here we have UA Perfect Ace. I think the UA stands for Ultra Athlete. That's what we think it stands for at the moment. These are going to become a very interesting archetype after we get some level 4s for them. And already we've got some pretty decent cards for them. Exchange of Night and Day, Artifact Chakram, and Despot 001. Now I'm going to very quickly lose count of all these packs because I'm just going to keep opening them until they're all done. Hippo Carnival, Shaddolls Skormata, Satellarknight Alpha, we have a Dogu, Pulau, Wind of the Yangzing, that's very nice. Pilgrim Reaper, I'm sure a lot of people are psyched about this card. The Monarch Stormforth, very useful support for any tribute decks. Yangzing Unleashed, and Feast of the Wild, level 5. I'll take out that Pulau. And we're going to the next one. Recover, that was one of the cards that we had a sneak peek of in the Primal Origins, I believe, box. Battleguard Rage, Satellarknight Unukalai, Agent of Entropy Uranus, Mozarta the Melodious Maestra, Fishborg Doctor, White Prince, Hymn of Light, and Despot 001. Now, if you're watching this video, it's probably good to keep track of the holos because that will help you try and predict how many how likely you are to get your own holo if you pick up your own copy of the box, because there tends to be a guarantee of a secret and an ultimate. But obviously that might have all changed, so we'll just see how it goes. Shaddoll Beast, that's a very good card for Shaddolls. UA Stadium, perform House Skeeter Skimmer. And we've seen all the rest of it before. So that was the other form of Gaia that we have to boost your Chaos deck. Satellite Alpha, Super Heavy Samurai Blue Brawler, Chaos Seed Hippocotable, Flash Knight, that's our first Pendulum Monster, so I'm going to put that over here. And we have our second Pendulum Monster, Foucault's Cannon, which is in super rare, very nice to get both Pendulum Monsters together, actually. So I'll just put that one with the hollows, and then we can have Flash Knight here, showing off the fact that he's very flashy as the first Pendulum Monster that we reached. So if you don't already know about Pendulum Summoning, it's probably a good idea to learn it. It's potentially going to take over the meta when Quillpots come out. It just allows you to spam a lot of monsters onto the field very quickly, and I think it can really boost some decks. So here we have Satellarknight Unkalai, number 58 Burn Advisor, Gaia the Polar Knight, Drac Ascension, Panzer Dragon, this is going to be pretty good with Instant Fusion, and we have Sonata the Melodious Diva, Gaia the Midnight Sun, Hymn of Light, and Pilgrim Reaper again. Nearly halfway through this box opening, and we're doing pretty well with three holo cards and two Pendulum Monsters so far. Uranus, Battleguard King, Satellite Alpha, Super Heavy Samurai Blue Brawler. Here we have Breaker the Dark Magical Warrior. This is the dark version of, obviously, Break the Magical Warrior, which we have before, and it's really nice to see it, actually. Got a very interesting effect. It's going to be very interesting to see this in play. Shaddoll Hedgehog, Satellite Vega, Nefarious Archfiend, Eater of Nefariousness, and Super Heavy Samurai Swordsman. There's two packs left for this half. And let's take a look and see what we can get. Battery Man, 9 volts, very good to see some support for Battery Man. Satellanova Wave, Artifact Lancia, Cloud Castle. We have Skarm again, Male Branch of the Burning Abyss. Oh, we have Secret, Odd Eyes, Pendulum Dragon. Here we go, see if I can try and get the sparkle effect going properly for you. This is one of the best Pendulum cards that we could have got. It allows you to search any Pendulum monster, and it has a very good monster effect as well. So yeah, this is one of the best cards you can get from the set. But obviously you can tell that from the rarity of Secret Rare, and it's really nice to be able to get a hold of this card. So I'm going to put that with the Hollows, and of course Battleguard Howling, Monarch Stormforth, and Curse of the Shadow Prison. So this is the last pack for the first half. See what we've got in it. Yangzing Piranha, Performer Pal Swordfish, Chain Dispel, Drac Ascension, and the Performer Pal Whip Snake again, and we have the Ultra Rare Doomstar Magician. That's very good against your Pendulum Monsters. So we've got really good Pendulum Monsters and really good Anti-Pendulum Monsters in this set. And here we have Performer Pal Hippo, Pilgrim Reaper again, and Gaia the Midnight Sun. Okay, now it's time to get on to the second half. See what we can get. Shaddoll Squamata, Recover, Area the Melodious Diva, Battery Man 9 volts, our rare is Super Heavy Samurai Big Benkei, Yangzing Unleashed, Exchange of Night and Day, Resonance Insect, and Sonata the Melodious Diva. We have another Metaphys Arm Dragon, Gaia the Polar Knight, Yangzing Piranha, number 58 Burn Advisor. We have another copy of Flash Knight, Jin Demolisher of Rituals, Shaddoll Hedgehog, Satellite Vega, and Super Heavy Samurai Swordsman. So we'll just put that Flash Knight there, just keeping the Pendulum Monsters separate. Because it's interesting to see a new form of card, especially one that you can get so easily from a booster box. Here we have Artifact Lancia, Battleguard Rage, Satellanova Wave, Shaddoll Falco, The Traveler and the Burning Abyss. Very nice super rare trap to go with your Burning Abyss archetype. Yangzing Unleashed. Feast of the Wild level 5. Performer Pal Hip Hippo. And Battle Guard Howling. We're going to run out of space for all these holos. And the next pack. Shaddolls Squamata, number 58, Burn Advisor, Chaos Seed, the Agent of Entropy Uranus, or Uranus, however you want to say it, Performer Pal Turntoad, very nice Pendulum Monster, Performer Pal Skeet Skimmer, That Six, Artifact Chakram, and Jin Demolisher of Rituals. So now we have a second non-holo Pendulum Monster. Spicy Spy, Performer Pal Swordfish, Battery Man 9V, Recover, we have Mozarta again, Nefarious Archfiend, Eater of Nefariousness, if I must say the whole name, Hymn of Light, Despot 001, and Resonance Insect. Let's see if we can get another holo to go with that. Metaphys Armed Dragon, Chaos Seed, Artifact Lancia. We have a second Burning Abyss monster. This is Graf, Male Branch of the Burning Abyss. Oh, sorry, did I say the other one wrong? Oh, well. And here we have Saphira, Queen of Dragons. Very, very shiny. This is an ultimate rare card and an incredibly awesome ritual monster. It's great to see ritual monsters back in the game after so long. I think it's brilliant that they've managed to bring back these cards. Even, like, they're bringing in the new stuff, like the Pendulum Monsters and all different sorts of archetypes, and they're still coming back to Ritual Monsters. It's just a brilliant set, this. Performer Pals, Skeet Skimmer, Feast of the Wild level 5, Shaddoll Hedgehog, and Yangzing Unleashed. So we'll put Saphira here. So we've now had a secret and an ultimate, and we'll do a recap of all of the holo cards, and we can actually go over the rares as well at the end. Let's take a look. Super Heavy Samurai Blue Brawler, number 58 Burn Advisor, Cloud Castle, Performer Pal Swordfish, Panzer Dragon, Artifact Chakram, Pilgrim Reaper, Sonata the Melodious Diva, and Performer Pal Skeeter Skimmer. Only 4 packs left. Battle Guard Rage, Hippo Carnival, Battery Man 9V, Satellarknight Unukalhai, Performer Pal Whipsnake, Shaddoll Core again, a brilliant holo. Great to see some awesome Shaddoll cards in here. This is a super rare trap, which is essentially a monster trap. I've seen a lot of those recently, and I really think this is very useful for a Shaddoll deck. Then we have Satellite Vega, Super Heavy Samurai Swordsman, and Nefarious Archfiend, Eater of Nefariousness, the card which will make me say words for the rest of my life. Here we have Battle Guard King, Yangzing Piranha, Recover, Super Heavy Samurai Blue Brawler, Performer Pal Kaleidoscorp, that's another very nice Performer Pal Pendulum Monster for us. Hymn of Light, The Monarch Stormforth, UA Stadium, and Fishborg Doctor. Oh, I miscounted. We have this one and then 2 more packs left in the box. Here we have Shaddoll Squamata, Hippo Carnival, Battle Guard Rage, Satellanova Wave, Super Heavy Samurai Big Benke, Performer Pal Hip Hippo, Shaddoll Hedgehog, Jin Demolisher of Rituals, and Gaia the Midnight Sun. Let's see if we can get another holo in the last 2 packs. Satellarknight Alpha, Battle Guard King, number 58 Burn Advisor, Shaddoll Squamata, Dogu, Curse of the Shadow Prison, Super Heavy Samurai Swordsman, Satellarknight Vega, and UA Stadium. Okay, it's time for the final pack. Let's see what we can get. Performer Pal Swordfish. The Agent of Entropy Uranus. Dracocension. This is... Or Male Branch of the Burning Abyss. I think that might actually be the last Burning Abyss that's not Dante. And Yang Xing Creation. Oh, we have another copy of the Ultra Rare Trap, which makes Yang Xing's incredibly broken, in my opinion. Battle Guard Howling, Feast of the Wild Level 5, Hymn of Light, and Shaddoll Hedgehog. So it's time to take a quick break, and then we'll do a recap. Core Kingdom is a UK-based website which sells collectible trading cards from many popular series, including Yu-Gi-Oh!, Magic the Gathering, and Pokemon. They frequently hold discounts, so head online to find out about their coupon system. Their products include the latest booster packs and boxes, as well as brand new decks available to pre-order. Shipping is quick and painless. Even though I live on an island, all of my orders from Cool Kingdom have arrived within a day. So go ahead and check them out at coolkingdom.co.uk. So it's time to do a quick recap of the higher rarity cards from this box. So we start off with our rares. We have Satellarknight Starbridge, UA Perfect Ace, Breaker the Dark Magical Warrior, two copies of Panzer Dragon, two copies of Mazata the Melodious Maestra, two copies of Dovu, two copies of Super Heavy Samurai Big Benke. We have a Shaddoll Falco, a Shaddoll Beast, and then we have one of each of, the Male Branch of the Burning Abyss cards, and a second of Skarm. Then we have three copies of Performer Pal Whipsnake, and for our Pendulum Monsters, which are rare, we have Performer Pal Kaleidoscorp, Performer Pal Turntoad, and two copies of Flash Knight. And then into our supers and higher rarities, we have our super rare Foucault's Cannon, a very nice super rare pendulum monster for you to improve your pendulum deck. We have Pulau, Wind of the Yangzing, excellent worm card for the Yangzings. We have the Traveler and the Burning Abyss, great trap card for the new archetype. We have Shaddoll Core, really awesome super rare. Two copies of Yang Xing Creation in Ultra Rare. Really awesome card. Gonna make the deck super good. Ultra good, even. Doomstar Magician. Very good against your Pendulum decks. Then we have the Ultimate Rare, Saphira Queen of Dragons. An incredible new ritual card, which is just incredibly good. You have to get a hold of this card. And of course, Odd Eyes Pendulum Dragon, the cover card for the boosters. This has to be one of the greatest cards available in the set. It's so useful in so many decks. Just, why not go ahead and pick up your copy of Duelist Alliance today, and you have every chance of picking up your very own Odd Eyes Pendulum Dragon for your deck. Thank you for watching this unboxing of the Duelist Alliance Booster Box for Cool Kingdom. Go ahead and check out the website. The link is, of course, in the description. It's www.coolkingdom.co.uk. Don't forget the cool is spelled with a K. Really fun unboxing. A lot of great cards in this set, so why not go ahead and pick up some boosters, because there's every chance that you'll get your hands on some of the best cards available.